Don't surely you look, amen, like somebody else that I seen on TV. But it don't always have to be in the look. It's the anointing. It's the relationship with God. It's the fellowship with God. Amen. It's knowing God. Amen. Knowing him to be who he say he is. A true relationship with him. That makes the difference. After all of them had passed by, Eliab, Abinadab, Shammah, all of them men, all the brothers had passed by. Samuel almost messed up and poured oil on somebody. God said, no, I ain't choose him. My God, don't mess up this time. Look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, whatever you do, don't mess up this time. Don't mess up this time. Amen. Jump in the gun. God got something special for you. God got something with his mind of design. And all he wants us to do is to be patient.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
While God is working this thing out, let God let his choice be your choice. Sometimes it may not look like you thought it should look. But it could be God. Could it just be God? Blessings comes in disguises. Make sure that your ears is open to hear what God is saying. Well, let's move on. And the Bible says, 10th verse says, and Jesse made 7 of his sons to pass by before Samuel. And Samuel said unto Jesse, the Lord have not chosen thee. God's choice is not going to be what we want.
Amen.
All the time. His choices. We just got to humble ourselves. And know that we want God's blessing on what he gives us and not man. Because man's choices would do like the previous king, Saul. Would be disobedient. Have his way, do his own thing, terrorize, is not of God. Lording over God's people, we're not to be Lord over them. The Bible says that there's one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. You have to lead the sheep. Sheep is not driven. Sheep are led. Bible says, 11th verse, and Samuel said unto Jesse, I hear all thy children. And he said, there remaineth yet the youngest. When he say call all your sons, that meant all. What do all mean? 7 and leave the one out? When God tells us to do something, he wants us to do just that. It's a blessing in being obedient. Like I said, sometimes your blessings come through the likely source. Something that somebody or something that you're not even expecting. God got a way of causing his blessings to run down the street and overtake you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Bible says, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, and fetch him. Now that's just, you know, a country. Go get it. Amen. Send and fetch him, for we will not sit down until he come hither or here. We're not going to sit down until he come. When God puts something in your spirit, you're not going to settle for less. But when God puts something in your spirit, that's what you stand on. No matter how the enemy seems, they're counterfeit. No matter how all of these come before, God will manifest. Stand.
Yes.
On the word of God. If God has given you a word, keep standing on it.
Amen.
It's been a while, but keep standing on it.
Yes.
Years have come and gone. Keep standing on it. Because God got a blessing with your name on it.
Yes.
And it's for you.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah. And he sent and brought him in. Brought him in. Mm-hmm. Now watch this now. He wasn't tall like the others. He probably didn't smell like them because he was out there with the sheep. Y'all don't hear me. Keeping the sheep out in the pasture. He wasn't thinking about being no king. Don't you know God is bringing people from the back to the front? Y'all don't hear me. Bringing them from the back to the front. Some unknown people is doing great things in Christ. And God is pulling the cover off of some of those that's been sitting in the high chair.
Come on, come on, say that.
Thank you, Jesus. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Now, the Bible says, now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and God goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise. I mean, that's an urgency.
That is.
I mean, you don't have to procrastinate. You don't have to wonder if he's the one because the way he looked and the way he smelled. Arise. When God tells us arise, do we tell God, okay, give me about 5 more minutes. I got you. I need just 5 more minutes. No, arise! Sometimes when we procrastinate, we miss our blessings. Things God has for us. He wants us to make haste and arise. Anoint him, for this is he. For this is he, this little shepherd boy. He's going to be a great king, a man of my own heart, the apple of my eye. Anoint him. Anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Mm-hmm. 14th verse. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul. Mm-hmm. And an evil spirit.
Yep.
Come on now. Evil spirit. God can sense an evil spirit. Mm-hmm. Evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. God can do anything he want to do, and the thing about it ain't nothing any one of us sitting in here can do about it.
Right.
He can do when he want to do it and how he want to do it.
Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul. It's a bad thing to think that you still anointed, but you've been stripped. Come on here. You think you still anointed, but the Spirit has lifted. I believe they call that Ichabod. The glory of God, the Spirit has gone out the building. Departed. And here you are, still thinking you're going to lay hands on somebody. You better watch that. Come on, Pastor. You're going to lay hands on somebody, and the Spirit is not on you. I don't care if you're Apostle Doohickey. If the Spirit has gone off of you, you better go sit down somewhere. And let somebody pray for you. God's choice, let God's source be your choice. Let God's source be your choice. Because God is our source. What we have is resources. And I want to help somebody here today. Hallelujah. Amen. So what that job closed? So what they phasing this out and phasing that out? The Bible says that I've never seen the righteous forsaken. David. Nor you see begging bread. What we have to do is be encouraged. And I got something from the former first lady as I was just meditating and praying this week. You know, they was always trying to discredit the former President Obama. But I heard her say something, and it just stuck with me in my spirit. She said, when they go low, we go high. So in other words, don't let people keep you down there and you know, they hit below the belt and doing dirty. Don't let that discourage you when you're going through things, when you feel like you're overloaded and seem like you're carrying the weight of the world on your shoulder. Just know that God said the work that he has begun in you, he will perform it. So don't be discouraged, but be encouraged. Hallelujah. For in due season, saints of God, ye shall reap if you faint not. I don't know about you, but I made up my mind that I'm going to let God make my decisions. Tired of suffering the consequences of making the wrong choice. If you let God, he will. Song said, let go and let God, he will. There's some things that God has blocked, even though you made the choice, but God blocked it. He didn't let happen to you what should have happened. But he blocked it. I can see it in the spirit. So what we owe God, we owe him everything. Because of who he is. And the Lord said he shall bring it to pass. It shall come to pass. But we got to start stepping on those little demons in our life. We got to tread upon them. Tread upon the scorpions and the serpents. Hallelujah, because he's given us power to do it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is raising up in these last and evil days. Hallelujah. God said, we have to sanctify ourselves. And I know you may not want to hear this, but amen. It's going to take some fasting through here. I hear fasting. Fasting is what's going to get us in the presence of God and get our marching orders and keep us together as the body of Christ. Because there's a whole lot of things that's perpetrating around the church and in the church. And so we're going to have to use the strategy that God gave Samuel to go down to Jesse's house for a sacrifice. But it was more than a sacrifice. It was to choose a king. And God, sometimes he'll send you one way, but there's another purpose in mind of God. And all we got to do is trust him and be obedient to his will. And it's not going to take long, because God is speeding things up, because time is moving so fast. Can I get a witness here? Look like I just had a birthday. When I was a teenager, come on, birthday, so I could be 21. Come on here. Now I done got 21. Now I'm saying slow it down. I can wait a while. You know how it is. Jesus. Amen. Give the Lord a hand praise. Come on, give him a hand praise, everybody. Hallelujah. We're going to extend the invitation. Maybe someone here today don't have a church home, and the Lord is speaking to your heart about becoming a member of Cornerstone Church of Chicago. If there'll be one today, I want you to come. Glory be to God. God bless this young man that's coming. Hallelujah. This is Apostle Dr. Clendora Harris' grandson. He'll be going to the military, I believe, later on this month. And we, amen, he wants put his name on the church roll, and we will certainly cover him while he's there. And when he come back, this is his church home to come to. There'll be another. I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. Lord, I love you more than now this one. Heaven is rejoicing over just one. Amen. And we thank God for this young man. Amen. Young men. There's a whole lot of stuff going on with the young men in this city. And when God draws them into the household of faith, it's just a blessing. Amen. For them to have a made up mind to come in. Amen. And give their life to Christ. Amen. I'm going to hear from the secretary.
He desires to become a member of the Cornerstone Church of Chicago. He is coming on his Christian experience, and he is coming as a member of Greater Helping Hands International Ministry.
Amen. Praise God. Let's say amen, everybody. Yeah. And thank God for Brother Brian.
Byron.
I'm sorry. I called him Byron. Amen. Thank God for him today. Amen. Coming on this Christian experience. Amen. As I said, so much going on with the young men in this city. All of them need to be in church sometime. Amen. As never before. And to know the Lord for themselves and seek after him and pray and learn. You got to start somewhere. Amen. You know, sometimes they miss that you know, the Sunday school class, but the, you know, they grown now. But you start somewhere. Amen. Get in the Lord for yourself. Amen. Brother Byron, you have something to say?
Preach! Preach!
Amen. We thank God for him today. I know his mom and his family.
Amen.
And I knew him when he was a little fella. I'm sure I did, around the church. And I even grew up. Amen. Taller than me. Amen. You know, we look like twins. So, we thank God for him. God bless you. Brother Byron, would you stand, please? May we put it through motion that Brother Byron. Depart.
Amen.
Byron Depart, become Apostle. A member of Cornerstone Church family.
Amen. Apostle and Cornerstone family, I make a motion that Brother Byron Depart, who's coming on his Christian experience, after the right hand of fellowship, receive all rights and privileges as any other member. Apostle, I second.
Amen. It's been moved and seconded. Anyone ask the entire church to stand as we come around and extend to Brother Byron Depart, the right hand of fellowship, and after which he have all rights and privileges as any other member.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise. Thank God for Brother Bonnie and Park. Amen. Today, we thank God for our guests and brethren, the body of Christ, and the visitors that's visiting today. We thank God for this harvest service that we have every year. Amen. We have two tables. Sometimes we have four tables. But today we have two tables. Amen. Of fresh fruit and vegetables on the table. But before we go any further, we're going to have Pastor Quinton Brown come and just bless us with something. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord again.
Glory.
We send holy greetings from New Beginnings Worship Center in Peoria, Illinois. We are so glad to have an opportunity to be here this morning. Me and First Lady Brown, Tanya Brown, my dog Candace, and my son Elijah. And we are here because of the visit. First of all, we're getting away for just a few days. Little R&R, that's one of the things that I believe pastors and leaders should do, get a chance just to escape a little bit. Also, gives you a chance that God can meditate with you and bring vision back to the church.
Yeah.
And so we got a chance to get away, and we're also want to get a chance to swing by our former church, another church, because we're having a church reunion. Bringing a lot of the leaders back, a lot of different ones back for a wonderful celebration this afternoon. So we swung to town to also be a part of that. So it's going to be a wonderful occasion there. But it's so glad to be here at Cornerstone Church of Chicago with these wonderful leaders that have been mentors for us. Apostle Cleveland Person, Apostle Francis Person, and the wonderful things that you're doing here. And when you see her, tell her I said, praise the Lord. You know, she's in Atlanta, having fun with our friend Margaret down there and doing some business as usual. But it's so good for the people of God and to come together, to fellowship together, and praise the Lord together in the beauty of holiness. This is what it's all about. And so we decided this morning just to come and be a part of service. And we just heard this wonderful message. This morning, and while he was talking and God was using him, I got about three messages out of his message to take home. It's interesting. Being a preacher, you can dissect the message and just hear God and start talking to him. And I'm already done for the rest of the year because I already know God told me all through your message. just awesome, awesome what you can pull out of the Word of God. For your own self. The one thing about it, and I think he can appreciate this too, the wonderful thing that I'm so glad about is the fact that I can step out of my pulpit on Sunday morning and don't have to worry about what's going on at home.
Yeah.
And this is what every pastor in the world wants to be able to do. And one of the things that I'm teaching my church, and I was talking to one of my leaders this morning that was asking me about if I'm going to be back in the morning. One of the things I told him was the fact that the reason why I'm training y'all is so I don't have to be back. The reason why I'm imparting all of this stuff inside of y'all is that you can be what God has called y'all to be, and to be the helpmates to the church that the leader needs you to be. And so that is the reason why I'm so glad that I can step away and do the things that God can allow me to do, and also home is taken care of. One of my friends, we got a saying, you don't ever want the church to be about a man, but the man. And that's what it's all about. It's never about a person, it's never about us, but it's Jesus Christ Church. And so that church, and like every church, should be able to go on forward if the leader's there or not. So my prayer is here that you lift up the hands of your leaders, keep them encouraged, let them be able to do the things that God has called them to do, and so that God can continue to bless this place. We
thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you, Pastor Brown. Amen. First Lady, you have something you'd like to say today? Amen. God bless you. We thank you so much for taking time out to come back. Cornerstone, I know you know a whole lot of people in Chicago. So we thank God that you, the Lord, that you're here to be with us in fellowship today, you and your family. It's just a blessing. And you can tell strong leadership, as Pastor is saying, when he's away, all the way up here, and the church is going on. Amen. It's absent. That's just going to show you how to have impartation into your members and teach them and train them how to carry on. Because it's not about, as he said, man, but it's about the man. And that's what we believe in at Cornerstone, that we all can step up. Cornerstone can step up when we're away to carry on in Jesus' name. Amen. That's what we should be doing, producing after our own kind. You know, producing after ourselves. Amen. Praise God. We thank God for each of you today. Anybody have any word they want to give, Elder McClendon? Hallelujah. Anyone else? We thank God for our guests, our visitors. You feel right at home, and you can stand up and have something to say. Amen. Anyone? God bless you, woman of God. Looking forward to this afternoon, the harvest service. We just thank God, amen, for your prayers. Continue to keep us in your prayers as we do the same for you. Amen. Amen. If that being all, let us stand. With me. are each one. You are important to me. I need you to survive. I pray for you. You pray for me. I love you. I need you to survive. I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. I need you to survive. It is His will that every need be supplied. You are important to me. I need you to survive. Our Father God, which art in heaven, Lord Jesus, we come before your almighty throne of grace. First of all, let's say thank you. Lord, we thank you for this service on today. We thank you for each and every one that crossed the door today. Oh God, we just pray a special manner upon the sick, the suffering, the shedding, the bereaved families everywhere. Lord, remember your daughter, Apostle Francis, person that's in Atlanta, Georgia. And so to keep her safe and let her have sleep, travel back on tomorrow morning. God, we pray. We thank you for Pastor Quinton Brown and his First Lady and Brown being here all the way from Peoria. And so to keep them safe and Lord, give them traveling grace. And coming with your blood as they make their way back home when that is. Oh God, we pray today for each and every leader. We pray for the fivefold ministry. God, we pray for those in leadership. Remember President Trump today and the entire White House. Oh God, they're standing in need of prayer. Oh God, we just pray today. Oh God, for each and every one. Pray for our enemies, those that despitefully use us and hate us without a cause. And so to bless us, do we come down from Zion and go to our many different places? Oh God, seal safely through and bless that everything is in divine order when we reach our destination. God, we pray today. Oh God, look and have mercy, oh God. Pray for our young men and young women as well that's in the street that don't know you and are part of their sins. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. Remember those in the hospitals and jails and various institutions all over this land. Now, Father God, we ask these blessings, all the blessings of your Son, Jesus' name, we do pray. Now, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest freely and abide with thee from henceforth and forevermore. Let's all lift our voices and sing. Thank you.